clean. Watch your head.
Well, he's looking for the right hand now, Zichit Commey.
There is the punching power of Mokwana. He'll need to do more of that.
Oh, Mokwana getting a beating now, round two.
Break, guys.
Mokwana's last fight was in March 2014. A points loss to Olisani Ndongeni. Oh. Big right hand again. He leads with that right hand. Explosive, explosive punching power from Richard Commey.
Yeah, you're right, Pomrani. It's explosive. I mean, he bombs that right hand and he's got such leverage behind it.
You gotta look at the balance though. Yes, he's throwing punches, but look if you, there, right there. Lovely camera work. You see the balance? Lovely, because now there it is, right there. It shows you now the balance of his supports, his punches with his body, because he's got such lovely balance, Richard Commey.
Well, it's all Richard Commey, one-way traffic in this Commonwealth lightweight title fight. There we see hands of stone, Ladwaba, a former great IBF champion. Of course, he lost to the great Manny Pacquiao, who fights the great Floyd Mayweather on the 2nd of May. Hands of stone, Ladwaba. See slow-mo action there, round two. As Pomrani says, this guy is so explosive, this Richard Commey. He bombs in all those punches. Boom, there's a right uppercut. Boom, over and right. And everything is explosive.
Round number three. Box. Commonwealth title at stake. Mokwana down in round number one. Made the right adjustments, tighten up on his defense in round number two. But again, what you are watching is the power punching display of Richard Commey.
Break, guys, break. John Paul.
It remains unclear though, Brian, what Mokwana has to do to get back into the fight.
Well, he's gonna start by applying a bit of pressure, which he's not doing. He's felt that big punching power from Richard Commey. And he's on the back foot. And there's no way he can win the fight on the back foot.
Break. Break. Break.
Mokwana forced to hold. Misses with the left hand uppercut this time. Commey. Ah, he's tripping up on the jab. You know, if you are ringside, you also get to hear the sound of the punches that are thrown by Commey. It's like a heavyweight is punching.
Yeah, the amazing thing is that he's got such long arms and leverage. He could fight well on the outside, but he likes to be on the inside. And he bombs them in.
18 of his 20 opponents did not stay in the ring to hear the sound of the final bell.
Oh, but have a comeback round from Thomson Mokwana, but he's still getting hammered.
Break, break.
Just a minute left in round number three. That's where
break,
the problem
break,
is.
Break, 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 break. Watch your head. Watch your head.
Commey can punch, yes, but he is disciplined enough to respect his opponent. Very tight defense.
Big jab there from Commey.
Some trainers would say to Thomson Mokwana, try and force him back and see what type of a fighter he is, if he is made to go back. Because right now, all the advantage, all the fight, all the initiative is with Richard Commey.
Yeah, it's one-way traffic. Richard Commey's cruising out.
Fox.
And he won the first round probably 10-7. Second round, 10-8. And he's busy winning the third round, has come in.
Stop!
Another good round. There's Ramakholi, the junior flyweight. Terrific little fighter. All the way from Soweto to Bang Ramakholi. There's the knockdown over the top. Boom. Great stuff from Richard Commey. The Bang Ramakholi, of course, sitting with his father. He had ringside. And he's a terrific fighter from Soweto. But back to the fight to the right hand from Richard Commey. Doesn't get much better than that.
Just in case you are in doubt, it's going to be round number four. If the number is held up like that, you simply cannot miss it. Yes, indeed. It is round number four at the Palace of Dreams. It's Thomson Mokwana in those red and white trunks with a touch of blue, challenging Commey in black trunks, who is from Ghana.
Well, Richard Commey getting away with a lot of Vaseline on the face. Referee hasn't picked it up. Oh, but that right hand. And down
two,
goes.
Three.
Our South African,
four,
Thomson Mokwana.
Five.
Again.
Six. Seven. Eight. You what?
I'm right, but it's sitting over. Over.
Okay. No. Sorry. No. Ten. Hold there. Ten. 5 minutes.
5 minutes,
five minutes.
Low blow. Mokwana needs this time.
Oh, well, not sure. We wait for the replay.
5 minutes. How do you feel? It's okay. Okay, hold on. You must watch your clothes, don't hit another leg. Right? Okay. Time in. Box.
Mokwana says it's good, it's okay to continue. Referee correctly saying you do have 5 minutes. That's exactly how it is. He could have used the maximum of 5 minutes, but he says it's okay to continue.
No. Watch your clothes. No. Go there. Time.
Another low blow, says referee Alan Machakane.
5 minutes.
Another five minutes.
5 minutes.
Well, Mokwana says it's low. The ref is giving him 5 minutes.
This is a strong warning. This is the last time now. You do it again, you're gone. Okay.
Good referee. I'm giving you a strong warning. Obviously, what follows would be a deduction of a point.
It's okay. Okay. Time in. Box.
For the second time in the round.
Watch your blows, guys.
We've had a low blow and a stoppage because of the low blows. Once you've been warned on several occasions for low blows, it forces you then to switch your attack and start concentrating now on the head. Let's see though if Commey is gonna try and go back to that body. What does he believe? Does he believe it was low blows, or Mokwana simply does not like body punches? Let's see what Commey believes. Let's see if he goes for the body.
Yeah, Commey doesn't even need to go for the body. He's when he lands to the head, he hurts Thomson Mokwana. Oh, there's a right hand up the top from Richard Commey again.
Mokwana should be taking the initiative right now. This is the moment. As they are posing, bobbing, weaving, it's Mokwana who should be chirping. But he's waiting yet again for Commey to fire first.
Break.
Oh, that was a good body shot.
He still goes downstairs. So he believes what I was thinking. Break. My opponent break. Doesn't break. Like body shots.
Break. Don't punch.
And Mokwana's getting a boxing lesson. He's getting a fighting lesson. And he's getting a beating.
Stop!
Oh. As the bell went, Commey landed one to the short roof.
That eye, work on his eye, make him think about that eye. But if you're going to let him just dictate, then it's, we're going to have a problem. But you see, you've got to stand tall because you've got a nice uppercut.
Okay.
And he slips, so it's in and out. You stay tall.
You see the lovely young ring girls here at Empress Palace. And of course, this is your mecca of boxing in this country.
Hold on.
Empress Palace, your palace of dreams. Four title fights tonight brought to you by Cheese and Yama. Golden Gloves, your promoters. Rodney Berman bringing you the best fights of your life.
This is round number five for the Commonwealth title held by Richard Commey in those black trunks. Thomson Mokwana from South Africa is the challenger.
Mokwana does not.
There's a good body punch. He's holding again. Stop. He's going to get a strong warning.
This is a strong warning. You hold again and take a point. Box!
Now he's at risk of losing a point in a fight. He's already losing.
Oh. That wasn't love. That was the body.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You want? Hand up, blue. You want to fight?
I want to fight.
Box.
Boxer is saying under belt. Ref says you want to fight. Boxer says yes, I want to fight. Guts and determination. That's what Thomson Mokwana is displaying here tonight.
Good call from the referee because we get the advantage of seeing a slow-mo. The referee doesn't see it at all.
Box.
He's got to call it straight away. And the referee called it as a body punch. And it was very accurate. Thomson Mokwana is trying to claim low blows here, but he's getting hurt in the body.
He's already received a strong warning for holding. Oh, lovely uppercut. Commey. Look at how he picks his punches.
I don't think this fight's going to go much longer as he gets caught in the right hand again. Thomson Mokwana is in serious trouble. You're in round five. And
stop.
It's all Richard Commey.
Go there. Stop. Go there. Come. 1 point for holding. 1 point for holding.
Oh,
1 point for holding. Listen. Don't hold.
I suppose the referee's taken a point, but he's also taken the advantage away from Commey, who was banging away.
Bleeding from the mouth. Thomson Mokwana, right now, he looks a beaten fighter, but he is a Manny Fernandez, got a towel in his hand.
Break, guys.
Yeah, Manny Fernandez got a towel in his hand, but he's taking a beating at Thomson Mokwana. I don't think he's going to be around much longer.
Sometimes you have to protect your fighter, your boxer. He can fight another day. He is up against it here tonight. There is Manny with the towel.
Oh, big body punch again. It's all Richard Commey.
They will have to be serious negotiations in Thomson Mokwana's corner. Do they let him come back?
Stop
for more punishment. What chance does he have of turning things around here tonight?
Right? What? strong. Because if you don't box now and take the fight to him, I'm going to stop the fight. You have to take the fight now. Don't wait for him. You showed him too much respect, man. Come on, go first. Let him see what you can do. Punch, man. And don't punch slow and be scared. Be strong. Punch, I'll win you one round. It's not right punch, man. If you don't know, I have to stop the fight. Come on, man. Big one. I don't want you to stop this fight. Please, come on. Not looking good at
Well, I think it was good advice that Manny Fernandez gave his fighter, Thomson Mokwana. I'm giving you one more round. You've got to pick up the pace, go forward, or I'm stopping the fight.
Amazing. A boxer says, I am strong. I am feeling good. He has a heart of a fighter, Mokwana. He needs to be throwing more effective punches, though.
Richard Commey seems to have taken his foot slightly off the pedal here.
Well, he's listening to you right now, because now he's throwing bombs again.
Yeah. That's all he knows is bombs.
Look how he switches that right hand to the body.
Break! Break! Stand behind his head. Let's go.
Nice jab. Commey, beautiful left jab. That cut on the side of his left eye hasn't given him problems, largely because that blood is not flowing direct into the eye. There goes Mokwana. Everything missing. Nothing landed.
Oh, there comes Commey with an uppercut.
Bleeding from the mouth, bleeding from the nose. Thomson Mokwana holds on.
Watch your head, watch your head. Let's go.
Thomson Mokwana in serious trouble.
No. Okay.
Wouldn't be surprised if he doesn't come out for the next round, is Thomson Mokwana. We've trained him many times. He's done stop the fight. Because he hasn't won a round yet.
He's shown a great chin and ability to take a good punch. But if you're a trainer, you don't want your boxer to show you that he can take a big punch, that he's got a good chin, because your game plan would be hit and not get hit.
Yeah, absolutely, Pumlani. You want to be around for another day. You know, you've got to save your fighter. And, I mean, this is just a one-way traffic. There's one guy in the fight. Break. Not even close.
Break. Don't talk. Let's go.
Yeah. It's almost where Manny Fernandez had the towel in his hand in the last round. I would throw it in. Oh, that wasn't the towel. That was the ring triangle.
What is happening?
But Tommy, you're showing me too much respect, and you're letting him come to you, you're letting him just hit you as you want. Deep rest. Right?
Richard Commey loading up with that right hand. And all he can do, Thomson Mokwana, is hang on for dear life. But he's made another round.
Hooks.
Thomson Mokwana comes back, answers the bell for round number 7 against Richard Commey. But as soon as he takes a step back, you know then that he's inviting trouble.
Oh, He's putting on the pressure now, Commey. He wants to finish
it. Stop. Don't hold. You want to fight? Over.
The referee asked him. Great referee, I must say. Andini Matakani, well done. He asked Thomson Mokwana, do you want to fight? Thomson Mokwana never even answered him. And referee Andini Matakani called an end to it.
He's
great
fantastic.
One by Richard Commey.
He's a lovely fighter. He's certainly one for the future. Very exciting. An explosive puncher from Ghana, Richard Commey. A display of boxing school skills too, because as soon as it became clear that he may not take Mokwana away easily, he resorted to his boxing skills, and then the openings came up again, and he took full advantage of those openings. Explosive, explosive puncher.
Yeah, great stuff. There we see Ndini Matakane again stopping the fight, and there we see the pressure punches from Richard Commey. Great attacking. And of course, he's a Golden Gloves fighter. He's been signed by Golden Gloves. And Richard Commey will be competing more on the Golden Gloves shows around the world. And yeah, in South Africa at Empress Palace, which is good news.
Thomson Mokwana displayed great heart, great determination. He was up for the fight, but he was really up against it. It's Thomson Mokwana who's been beaten by Commey here.
Ladies and gentlemen, it was the second title fight on this evening's Stand and Deliver card brought to you by Chisanyama. Let's give you the time. It was called by referee Alan Matakani 29 seconds into the seventh round. The winner by technical knockout, and still the Commonwealth lightweight champion from Accra in Ghana. It's Richard Christos Asonto Commey.
19th KO in 21 fights. Richard Commey, congratulations. What a fine display here at the Palace. Coming up next, Dwayne Combrink against Giovanni Bushbeam. This for the vacant WBA Pan-African middleweight title. It is scheduled for 12 rounds.
I want this boat. It's a nut for sale. I don't want to buy it with money. I want to win it. With a dance.
International cycling season live on Supersport, brought to you by Cecil Nurse, leaders in office furniture solutions.
Well, if you just joined us, Empress Palace. There we see the great Empress Palace, and this is where we are in this venue. Empress Palace, Johannesburg, South Africa, right next to the airport. As Bumlani said, planes are taking off all the time. Whose careers are going to take off tonight as we wait for our next fight? Dwayne Combrink versus Giovanni Bushbeam. Taylor the Tape, 23 years old, against 29. In fact, he's 21 years old. 1.79 as to 1.80, 1.82 reach, 1.85 longer reach to Bushbeam. And wait, they're waiting at middleweight. They fight for the vacant WBA Pan-African middleweight title. Dwayne Combrink, 12 fights, 11 wins, only a single loss. Giovanni Bushbeam, 11 fights, 6 wins. These two fought in December last year, and Gombrich won a unanimous decision over 8 rounds. So this is the rematch for the vacant WBA Pan-African middleweight title.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Stand and Deliver for title fights on the card this evening. All four of them scheduled for 12 rounds, two down, two to go. This evening's boxing proudly sponsored by Chisan Yama, promoted by Golden Gloves, and exclusive to your World of Champions Supersport. The third title fight on the card this evening is for the vacant WBA Pan-African middleweight title.